How much do I want for my Toyota Tacoma? Good morning, everybody. How are you today? Pretty good here. So how much money would it take for me to sell my Toyota Tacoma? You know, I got to thinking about this for a couple reasons. One, you know, recently I went out and made a video. I got on the old Caravana and was underwhelmed by the offer that I got for them for my Tacoma. But then shortly thereafter, I scheduled an appointment to do the first oil change. It's been a while since I got the truck, and it's due. It needs it. So I called Toyota. I made the appointment, all that stuff. And then I've been seeing off and on a lot of comments from people about them taking their Tacomas in to do some sort of service, you know, typically an oil change. And while they're waiting there, as is typical, the salesperson comes over and asks them if they're interested in selling their Tacoma, you know? Usually happens, it seems, when they're out nosing around the lot looking at the other Tacomas or vehicles, if you can find any, on the lot. And that's what I typically do, right? I wait on the truck. I don't just abandon it. I don't leave it there. It's a weird thing with me. But I'll go out and nose around the lot and see, you know, what they have, what options there are, and hopefully they'll have some Tacomas and Tundras when I go. They had a few recently when I was out there. So it got me to thinking, you know, what's going to happen if I get approached while I'm at the dealership and they ask me if I'm interested in selling my Tacoma, or further, even offer me something for it? What would it take? So, you know, you start to look at your truck a little bit. I mean, everything has a price, right? Everything has a price. Of course, if I sold this Tacoma, I would just turn around and buy another Tacoma. That would be the plan. So I got to thinking, you know, I have a lot of mods and things on this truck. And I know that a dealership doesn't care if you have mods or stuff on your truck, right? But I don't care, because in this instance, in my example, they're approaching me. And I care. So in going through the list of mods, and there are many, if you watch my channel, then you know I've done a lot of things to this truck. Everything from wheels and tires and lifts and roll bars and LED lights and grills and interior improvements and exterior improvements, all kinds of things, right? So I kind of have to put a value on that. And a while back, it might have actually even been on my red truck, when I had the 2018 Barcelona Red Tacoma, I went through and I listed everything and I came up with an amount, and it was somewhere in the, I think it was $12,000 to $15,000 range, something like that, if you add up every little bit and piece of everything that I had done. So I got to thinking, you know, if the same, and it's probably about the same on this truck, you know, there may be a few more things, and this truck actually was a little more expensive than that truck, because it's one that I spec'd out, I built, and I added everything to it. It's got the front and rear cameras, the tech package, the LED lighting, the sunroof, the leather interior. It has everything on it, right? So if we take a look at the sticker price, it was $42,000 some odd. We'll just call it $42 flat. And I'm going off the sticker price because, you know, the dealer is going to jack it up anyway, right? I mean, if I was to walk in there and sell it to them, you know, they're gonna jack it up from whatever they offer me. They have to. That's how they make a profit, right? So I'm going to start at that $42,000 mark. And, you know, if I add my $15,000 to it, what the mods are worth to me, my wallet, well, you're obviously at $57,000. Now, there's also labor in there. I mean, if I'd have paid somebody to do this, you know, heck, you probably could double that number. I don't know, maybe $30,000. So you're really looking at a $72,000 investment if I had to pay the labor. Now, except for the lift and, of course, putting the wheels and tires on, I just include that in the price. I've done everything else, so I haven't paid anybody to do anything. But still, I would have had to if I couldn't do it myself. Now, do I honestly think that I am going to get a $72,000 offer from the dealership? Well, of course not. They're not going to give me $72,000 for this truck. No way. But what's a realistic offer with the mods, in my opinion? And I'll tell you, it would have to be right around the $60,000 mark. That's what I would want for this truck if I was to sell it, whether it be, you know, to a dealer or to a private party, whatever. I would want 60 grand. That's what it would take for a couple of reasons. One, I'm not looking to sell it. You know, the truck is worth that kind of money to me, whether or not anybody will give me that kind of money or not. So since I'm not looking to sell it, that's what I would want. That's what it would take, 60 grand. The other thing is, you know, I would have to recoup some of the money. It'd be nice to recoup it all, right? But some of the money that I have in the mods. Again, given the scenario that I'm not looking to sell. You know, if I was going in there and I was trying to trade it off, obviously I would have to be a little bit more flexible on the price because I would be looking to trade. But like I said, in this case, I'm not the one that's asking. But that creates a whole nother problem. You know, I want a Tacoma. I need a Tacoma for the channel, and I want a Tacoma for myself. I love the Tacoma. But given, whew, that was a big bump. Felt like I was on the Dukes of Hazzard there for a minute. But the problem is there are no Tacomas out there. You know, if I was to sell my Tacoma, what would I do? Buy a used one? Pay new price for a used one, if I could even find a used one? And then we're limited. You know, trying to get the color or some kind of color that I want with the options that I want, I don't know that that would really be possible right now. So I would be in a bind. I would probably be without a Tacoma if I was to do that right now. So not likely that I'd be willing to do it even if they handed me a check for $60,000, because I would want to turn around and reinvest that in a new Tacoma right off the lot that day, right? I wouldn't want to go without a Tacoma for any period of time. Again, both for business purposes, this is my business, and secondly, for the love of the Tacoma, for wanting to have one. So the likelihood of me doing something like that is very, very slim. I would have to get the price that I want, and I would have to be able to grab another Tacoma like I want while I was there on the lot. Anyway, I just thought I'd get on here. I was thinking about that myself and bring you guys in on the conversation I'm having in my head. And that is, what would I do and what would my price be if indeed I was to consider selling the Tacoma? And that would be 60 grand with availability of another truck on the lot. Leave a comment, let me know. If you're kind of pondering the same thing, what would it take for you? Would you sell it at whatever price they gave you, or do you have some sort of a premium on yours as well due to maybe what you've done with it? I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, if you're interested, I do have an additional channel. It is Rob Motive JT, all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator. Check it out, and if you're interested, why not subscribe? Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.